Hey there, it's your man, Franchise, GPA, Greatest Sport Alive, and I want to drop in real quick and share what I like to call the Heart Race Mixtape. I love love, man. I think love is beautiful. I believe it exists, despite what people try to tell you. So this is my expression of it. I wanted to share it with you. Thank you so much for tuning in. Enjoy my poems. One. Real talk, I know flowers are expression of love, expression of affection. So, tomorrow being Valentine's Day, today being the day before and the day after being the 15th. I wanted to sing you roses.
Yeah, I did.
Let me compose myself. Here we go. I wanted to send you roses. The intent of me sending them to you might have got lost in the delivery, because I would have sent you roses of any color. If you had a preference, I would have sent you roses of that color, but any color except red, because, well, red is commonplace to me. Red is commonplace, and that's the total antithesis of you, red. But still, I wanted to send them. I wanted to send you roses. With no macabre machinations manifesting, peep the alliteration there. I would have sent you your favorite color roses, yellow, purple, pink, everything except red, like I stated previously. But with each and every rose, I would have made sure the thorns were included. I would have made sure the thorns adorned every stem of each rose of the dozen that I would send you. But I would have made sure that your fingers, your palms, none of your hand, none of your person would ever touch the thorn. But I wanted to send them. Stay with me. I wanted to send you roses. Let me alleviate your apprehensions. It's probably a sending. See, the roses with the thorns are a metaphor of you and I. I would be the thorns. Each and every thorn on each and every stem of the dozens of roses, I would be the thorn, protecting you, keeping you safe, making sure no harm ever come to you. You'd be the roses. You'd be the roses multiplied. Provide a protector. Beauty. You and I want to send you roses. We're gonna free flow this one a bit. We're gonna free flow this one. This is called I Told Your Friend. Walk with me. Walk with me. I knew you couldn't hear the contents of my voice. I knew you couldn't hear my tone attached to the contents of my heart speaking through my voice. I knew you wouldn't want to adjust your hearing to the syllables that I was spitting to you, so I told your friend. I told your friend what I had to say, so she would listen. And then when you ever mentioned love, you ever mentioned a good man that you were looking for, that you were searching for, then your friend had these instructions to tell you that every time you mentioned love, she would tell you that I said to her, so she could say to you that it was me. It was me knocking on your door, knocking on your window, knocking on the window and the door of your heart. It was me. Standing outside with a big sign like John Cusack and say anything. It was me. It was me. With the radio blasting your favorite love song, letting you know, hey, the guy that you were looking for, that was me. The next time that you mentioned that you put on a status somewhere and you say, oh my God, the love that I'm looking for, it'll never find me. Well, I did. I was standing right in front of you in plain sight. I was making sure that I shined really bright. I made sure that I carved myself in such of a stature that no superfluities on my body ever existed. I made sure that wherever you turned on, if you turned on the TV, click, I was there. If you walked inside a movie theater, oh my God, it was there. If I stood on a play stage, I was there. If I was in a champion circle of a storytelling event, I was there. If I was up for Poet of the Year and I won, I was there. There was no place that you couldn't go that you couldn't see me, but you didn't. The next time you get in your circle of girlfriends or you get in that thread where you have your chat thread and you're speaking, oh my God, I'm never going to find a man. The man I'm looking for who's successful, who's well-shaped, good-looking, da-da-da-da-da. Sis. It was me. It was me underneath your picture saying, hey. Not overzealous, but just hey. It was me in your inbox sharing poems with you, seeking to garner your attention. It was me. All along. That good man that you were speaking of, that well-dressed man, in shape man, charismatic, humorous, knew how to give it to you, man. That was me. So when you speak about love around your friend, when you speak about a man that you're seeking around your friend, when you speak as if it was some far-off thing in fantasy land that the Lord got to bring you, oh, Lord, please bring you, man, well, your friend is going to tell you what I told her. It was me. It was me. It's my poem. Franchise. Backpack Dog. Hope y'all enjoying yourself. Thank y'all for joining me. Let's finish this out. This is called Wishes. You were my Valentine before I met you. Just needed fate and destiny to catch up. I saw your beautiful face in my dreams, day and night. Fortunately, blessed in any other superlative synonym that I'm near you in real time, whatever that may be. And so long as the Lord allows me breath, heartbeat, and cognizance, forever my Valentine you would be. Wish one. I would like to pull your chair out, then scoot it back in, sit next to you and wait for the waiter. Take both of our orders for food, drinks, and desserts, and engage in talk, not small. Sweet whispers in between in your ear. The waiter would return and serve us both and check on us in proper intervals. And I'd pay the bill and leave the appropriate tip, at least 20%, and we depart holding hands. Wish two. I would like to watch the night become the day in your eyes. Give birth to furthered affection by inhaling and exhaling breath. Those are kisses, by the way. Discard the novelty of being among others, captivating their gazes, hearing them marvel. Oh my God, their relationship goals. Oh, they're so cute. They've been together forever. But live in the present, even when the moment becomes the past. Live in the present, even when the moment becomes the past. A day and forever. Wish three. Phone rings, designating a text from you. Eyes caress each syllable as if inches of your skin. A memory attached to your voice, to the printed words. Smile widens, then fades, but returns. Second message received. Your eyes wish to see me again. Wish four. Propaganda near over. Tangible, revealed. Roses, not red, delivered in all colors. Chocolate cover, whatever your taste buds desire. Kisses till we are breathless and lungs full again. Close and include the world in our adventure. Wish five. Drowning in the fountain of you to regain my youth. I release passion unbridled to the covers in the darkness that is me. I run to your light as if the beckoning was divine. Every moment of the day, every moment of the night, with every breath that I have, I send prayers of thanks to the Almighty, with hopes they are worthy of being heard. You stare into my eyes, telling me they are. Wish number 6, my poem. Thank y'all for tuning in.